This is crazy. Bro, strange, I mean, you know,
stuff in this country.
You're talking, let me tell you, I don't think I've understood the magnitude of the impact that you've had in the MC world. And I want to understand it. And I love it because I don't understand it. So I'm going to ask very layman questions to understand. Secondly, you've talked about this thing of doing free gigs. Every creative that I have in this space, I want to start talking about this exposure conversation.
Hey.
Because the narrative going out or that has gone out is don't do freebies. I think the narrative of don't do freebies, or I personally believe that the narrative of don't do freebies is to a specific group of people.
Mm.
You have to earn your stripes.
Mm.
What's your, first of all, what's your conversation about this exposure? And then we enter this jam that you did. Is it, I think, with the Kolo?
Yeah, Yeah, first transition, correct.
What's your exposure thing?
So you're right. You have to earn your stripes. This is like the military. I watch a lot of military movies. Mm. I love it because it shows the journey. No one is born a five-star general. Even if your father is the king. Even kina, those guys of the royal family, you had to start kurutu kidogo cadet nini. And then, you know.
It's true.
Then the opalishwe rasmi, sare rasmi. So, even a prince, like our president, did not get where he is immediately with all the money, connections, and resources. He was denied in Gatundu, failed in election in 1997. Kenyans rejected him in 2002. So by the time he's coming to win, after we campaigned for him, yeah, thank you so much. TNA,
Uruto, in 2012, 2013.
Ukanunua nyumba. Ndio, it was a good, you see, amepitia. No, ni mtoto wa rais wa kwanza wa nchi, Jamhuri ya Kenya.
Mm.
So, it's a journey. You just look at it like that.
Mm.
So even for me as an entertainer, I started doing free shows. I've told you from high school, I began curtain raising for guys who'd come to our school. Makini was a big private school, so funkies, nini, rugby, tonas, what? Symposium, napiga, shairi. Naji market, manze, naji promote. Also, you have to build your prowess and skill levels to a level where a client will want to pay you for this service.
Mm.
I remember starting off, in fact, money was not in the picture. All we wanted was an opportunity. All I wanted was an opportunity to get on stage. Kupanda stage ni kitu bigi, Esther, kama msanii chipukizi. Kupanda jukwaa na kupewa mikrofoni, ongea na watu, piga. Check, check, one, two, oh yeah. Yeah. Ni kitu kubwa. So, for the upcoming artists, lazima upitie. You must pass through the mud and then you come clean. Look at any successful entertainer today. They started somewhere, from Jay-Z to P. Diddy to name it. P. Diddy alifutwa kazi. Na kufungwa Bad Boy. Watu wamepitia mambo mingi. So like, I too went through the same motions of earning nothing, of somebody telling me they'll pay me and then switching off the phone. I've gone through it. Big promoters in this country, I've gone through it. I didn't have contracts at the time. I didn't even know what a contract is, or that I even deserve one. I didn't know my value, perhaps. I didn't know how to monetize it. So people would take advantage. A big shout out to Word of Life. They're the first guys to ever give me an honorarium. Honorarium is something you're given as a token of appreciation. We will appreciate you. I was in shock, man. I went back to my hotel room and I found a check of 3,000 shillings. Again, even to go to Mombasa, I'd used Coast Bus. Wow. And they had paid for me Coast Bus. They had given me my own room. Word of Life had like nice cottages. I was in disbelief. Like, it really touched my heart. Somebody had appreciated me like that. Because I was not used to earning. I started earning in entertainment, not as a musician, but as an MC.
Yeah.
I got my first...
But did you do some free MC gigs?
Yes.
So even if you enter a new craft, bado unarudi chini.
So now guess new DNG as an artist.
Yeah. Okay, go, even before we enter this MC, okay. Tungei song, yeah, the transition, the one with Kolo. Because your first, even before you've entered MC, you drop this secular collab. I hate using the word secular because for me, God created music.
Yeah.
We're the ones who put the versions of limitations on it.
Correct. Boxes.
You get
boundaries.
That God music is only one that talks about him.
Yeah.
God created music.
Correct.
You get what I mean? So, but according to what people will understand, your first secular song was
was Watasema Watachoka with Kolo. So I'd met Kolo before. We used to interact quite a bit in that sector of Nairobi West. So my designer that at the time was a guy called Ibra Mavazi Handprint. Used to do my t-shirts and stuff like that. So we had interacted in that collab. Then interestingly, when I was putting dreadlocks, the salon where I went to put dreadlocks in Nairobi West, Kolondo alinipeleka. So I put like really bad dreadlocks. And then later I was introduced to Steve Kumari, Roots Salon, big shout out. And he redid them properly.
And he reset them again. He walked through your whole dread life.
Till I had huko nyuma bana. I used to funga them here corporate na ingia na suti kwa ofisi ma client na sema, "Woo, italipa LPO." So it is what it is, man. Good life. So Kolo, we just created an amazing bond. And so I told Kolo, like, you know, man, I'm going through a lot of drama with these media guys writing about me, putting me on the newspaper, Pulse, Zuka, Buzz. I'm like, I'm tired of this nonsense, man. I want to do a song, talk about this nonsense. So that's how we came up with Watasema Watachoka, Kisha Usiku Watalala.
We, ebu tugia wase kitu ya kuongea juu na kama maheta na masnitch, matabloids, mapepa. Wanatafuta wasanii sana. We, DNG.
Yeah.
Ebu tugia wase topic, maze.
Aha. Twende.
Babs, maze.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, my baby number one, DGP, Gina DGP, Danny Booth, the underdog. I'll see you. You ready?
Underdog production.
But DNG, see what the same, what the choker. Kisha usiku watalala, lala, lala.
DGP, what the same, what the choker. Kisha usiku watalala, lala, lala.
Nani maze, what the same, what the choker. Kisha usiku watalala.
For the gangsters, DGP, what the same, what the choker. Kisha usiku watalala, lala, lala.
Kikulacho singoni mwako, kile unacho joni siri yako. During my lifetime, nimesha experience times za kulei kwa ditch. Mattress na duveju ya closer stitch, ha. Hustling life ya rapa, sparkling life ni ndoto tu kwangu juu ya backstabbers. Ni obvious nobody saw this, maisha nane kakat plani mwanangu victory flawless. Juu bila Mungu, mi singe kuwa hapa, singe kuwa superstar, singe kuwa rapstar. Ningekuwa tu mtukutu mshenzi tupu, sai na baki na mshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu. Ni realness ndo sako track na seti, next time think twice ukibai gazeti. So maheta na masnitch wote tukutane ba then. Minta sema hallelujah, wote jibu amen.
Watasema watachoka, kisha usiku watalala. 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 Fast usu najua TNG ndani ya nyumba. Na faji niko na ajwe na valisha kaptura. Ma haters hawani kuzi hata wakitaka. Mistari kali kama shoka na wakata kata. The big to huski round in this nimetoka.
Mbona joo
na wasela kubonga. Makafiri wanajua tu kuroboka. Stories isizo wahusu zina watoka. Nasikia nimeingiliwa na katablo ilfulane. Sipo baka eneo ofisini na mitaane. Ati man, numesikia the big news. Walai, ZNT hata okoka. Uski maze siku hizi ya me backslide. Round in this maze ya me tupa Christ. Uski alipatikana hivi na hivi. Na alikuwa anaharibu kisiri. Na wanabambika sana kawatoi. Maruma monga razma gosi pas kama maboy. Kitu fani hadhi hani tui. Hao nisikia tu, hawa ni mesei. Kila itumala zima muze gazeti ndio mna hustle tu chini. Kunitoa rangi, I been through the fire. Sasa hivi niko safi, niko fiti next Friday. Mtasema nini?
And this now is when I just joined USIU 2006. So even some of the guys you see in the video are my classmates. So this video, we shot it at my mom's garage, which now we transformed into a kaofisi, 254 later. And in that newspaper, I'm tearing up the Pulse magazine and throwing it onto the camera. Any Batman thing, it became a real crazy stuff. But and then those are the days now when there were music charts. So Watasema Watachoka was topping the charts on KTN, a Standard Media Group station.
And yeah, where I'm tearing their newspaper.
I don't know why they never looked into that.
They were,
but my fans walikuwa wanapiga kura wanasema watasema watachoka kisha usiku watalala, and that's the grit I'm talking about. So me, whether people talk bad about me, it doesn't matter. Me, I continue with my journey because my journey is not dependent on man Esther. Me, I answer to God. God is my judge. I may make mistakes. I'm not a perfect person. Even Jesus said, "He who is without sin, cast ye the first stone." Nobody threw a mawe, bana, even like a small one. Unaelewa? Tukianza kumulika maisha ya watu leo. Kila mtu akifunguliwa simu yake, email yake. last visited history on the browser.
Incognito.
Utashtuka hata mzazi wako. So hakuna mtu ambaye ana lawama. So nobody is perfect. Anyway, that we're not out here seeking perfection. We're just here to live a great life, a good life, and make impact as we go. And interestingly, I even remember back in the day, I always used to feel like God does not choose the perfect people to be his generals. He chooses the worst of the worst. Think Rahab, the prostitute. Think Gideon. David, the guy who had been left out of the lineup.
Unajua lineup by the folks.
Yeah.
His own father forgot him.
His own father forgot him. Alikuwa na mangombe huko na mambuzi. Paka Prophet Jesse akauliza, is there no
Samuel,
other?
Samuel,
I beg your pardon. Thank you. Jesse was the father.
Yeah.
Beg your pardon. So, is there no other? Have you no other sons? Ni akakumbuka, kuna kurutu fulani, kakona uchafu. Kumbe that was the king, baba. The anointing of God is not determined by background, weakness, mistakes, or past, or anything. God just decides you. His reasons are his reasons. And he does not need to explain them to man. We're not on the same level.
Hey.
Mungu akichagua, akisema atakubariki, hakuna atakayezuia. Do you understand how powerful that is? Watu wanaweza kubana. Watu wanaweza kubani for kuseme Esther hata waione TV show hata waionekana wa kusabotage, washinde wana comment matusi. Lakini akisema atakubariki, hakuna atakayezuia. It's prophetic. Mungu alichagua Paulo. Paul.
The murderer.
Paul on his way to Damascus. Ule jamaa alikuwa anaua watu. Do you know a murderer ni kama sai tuseme nani? Wale serial killer tunaonanga USA. Mm. Wale wanabeba AK-47 ama whatever. Anapiga watoto kwa shule.
Mm.
You see that kind of madness. Mm. These terrorists who blow up malls and shoot up buses of innocent teachers.
Yep.
God chooses such a person.
That's deep. Now I looked at Paul like that.
Prophet. That was a murderer. Mm. Murderer. See, ati anaua mtu moja by mistake.
And in fact, he was murdering saying
on
that
purpose.
I am protecting the religion
of
God.
Yeah,
these guys are
the
going
Pharisees,
against the yeah. Him, he thought he was working for God.
Correct.
So it's like Islam, guys. Not Islam, but I take that back. Not Islam, but terrorists who proclaim jihadism.
Yeah,
you get what I mean?
Yeah, it's a misconception. Strewed religion.
Yep.
Because Islam is a religion of peace.
Yep. That's what I'm saying. That's why I said I take that back.
So think of it. And there are many examples from the tax collector, the prostitute. Yani, Mungu ametumia wase. Even Moses, who could not stammer, who could not articulate and communicate his thoughts. He chose him and he said, you know what, juu ya hii makosa makosa yako, I will give you a translator. Mse ataku represent. Apie.
Aaron, your brother-in-law.
Yeah, akusaidie kuongea na wafalme. Mungu achagui ati ule mtoto mzuri. In fact, Christ came to save the lost.
Do you think that's you? Do you think you've been chosen on those same basis?
Yes, because me, I'm not a perfect person, Esther, in the least. But I have a good heart and a good spirit. And that is what leadership is about. Leadership, Esther, is God using an ordinary person with faults and mishaps and challenges to do extraordinary things. And it's through empowering that ordinary person with all those challenges that people laugh about or talk about to do greatness. It's through that God's strength and majesty shall be seen. Because if I was a perfect guy doing perfect things, you'd not see God's greatness.
Mm.
But he chose a guy who alikuwa anapiga ma suspension nini akashinda kora. You know what I mean? It's crazy.
Mm.
If you look at it from a layman's eyes,
no, it's madness.
But if you look at it from the in the spirit, you see God's work in place.
Okay, so what happens after you chomoka this? Okay, first of all, you join USIU. What are you studying?
I did an IBA. Mm-hmm. I studied IBA, International Business Administration. My concentration was in marketing, which is what I do for a living.
Mm.
Interestingly.
How was USIU for you?
USIU was...
Because now you've left what guys have called saved.
Yeah, yeah.
So, why were you... Okay, no, you just...
So before, when you say it was in UN.
Oh, you had a
diploma? UN? Yeah, in University of Nairobi.
How many years?
1 year.
Yo.
Yeah, diploma in business management. Then I joined Para. Then I realized, hey, yeah, I'm not achieving. You know, UN, na siongei vibaya, but at the time, it was not a very serious institution.
Mm.
Teachers would come when they feel like. Guys are not committed in education. I felt like it's not a university experience that I want to be a part of. My 1 year wasn't, I didn't feel like it was great. Then when I was exposed to other campuses, because I told my mom, I don't want to do para anymore. I want to look for a university experience. Like I craved that thing of I'm in a campus. Because para is usiku, they keep moving classes here. You don't really have a community.
Mm.
And then at UN Main, there's everybody everywhere. You follow?
Mm.
So I went, got application forms from different places. I'm like, hey, this is not it for me. This is the same as UN. So when I went to USIU to pick the admission application forms, and it's like a flyer
that talks about brochure.
Yeah, brochure, course outlines available, starting dates. I walked into that campus and I saw a whole different place. I saw a place that looked like it's not even Kenya.
Mm.
It's a beautiful campus. And I felt like this is the campus experience that I want. Where there's an auditorium, there's this, there's that, there's technology, it's fresh, it's organized. And that's why I chose USIU. My mom was against it. She wanted me to go to Desta because it's a Christian university.
Fifi's is not there.
Fifi's is not there. I'm like, bruh, that's not what I want to do. I told my mom, but this is the university I want to go to. If you feel like paying, tell me, but I mean, then I'm saying, 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 I'm saying,
now you're getting there. How old are you about this time?
2006, 20, turning 20. Because I joined in August.
Bruh, you're still young,
September,
man.
20 years.
So you've already had a full music career?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm mad.
And you've done 20.
Yes. So now I'm telling her, so anyway, baadaye alikubali, aliona huyu mtu hii. Ako serious. You know, sometimes I even encourage some young guys who tell me, I'm struggling to convince my dad that I want to do this degree or I want to pursue this career. I'm like, show them that you mean business. Sometimes, you know, we as parents, you look at your kid as that kid, that kid you raised. You're a parent, you will understand. So you don't really consider that your child can actually make decisions.
Yep.
So I think my mom was at that place. And when she saw I'm very serious, then we had, of course, she would keep reminding me, please, you have to finish. Once that towards in the middle of the nini, I told her I want to drop out of school, of university. Because I was earning money, and I felt class was wasting my time. Na kulado, naenda ma meetings, ma presentations, na Hawaii, na pewa ma LPO, na piga makazi, kubwa Kenya mzima. Many big brands. So it's like, why am I in school? Again, I'm on radio. I remember my radio boss then, Caroline Toko, telling me, if you drop out of school, that's the day you lose his job. So some people kept me in check.
Yo, bro, you
were earning. I had moved out of home. I was living on my own, paying my own bills. I bought my own car. I was filling my own car. I was paying rent and tax.
Like a Kenyan.
Yes.
Like you were paying tax.
Yes.
Bruh.
So at what point now is this school? I was not understanding.
What am I doing in school? Yeah. And I've already gotten the end product of what school
exactly.
Is supposed to give me.
Because my mom will tell me, go to school so you can get a good job. I already have a company. I'm already employed and I'm doing gigs. What more? And I'm employing others. I'm employing my schoolmates. Paying them salaries.
Samora. Why that was your business partner?
Samora came later. There's a guy called Meg Werunji.
Bruh, you've got too much.
A lady called Bihawa Swale. They were my employees. And we're in the same university, same year. Now Alipa, I told them, man, I've started a company. Come we work. Come we hustle. Nenda kupiga ido.
Okay, bruh. Let's
then Samora came later when we started doing events as an MC.
Okay.
And then became our operations manager.
Dude, yeah, you guys, you
shout out my G's.
You've taken me bio.
Yeah.
But I'm blown away by this. Yes, I remember. You went and in fact, we saw you go and explode instantly.
Yeah.
You get?
Yeah.
So what happened? So now you join USIU. At the same time, musically, have you joined Jomino?
No. I started with the Watasema Watachoka. Mm-hmm. Then after Watasema is when I joined Jomino. Then
At this time for Jomino, are you in USIU?
I'm in USIU, yeah. That's like my first year now.
Okay. USIU. Okay. So and when you're in first year, your campo hasn't not yet set up.
254, not yet.
Okay, good. Okay, good.
254, established in 2008, but I incorporated in 2009.
Okay. So in this story, while you're in USIU, what comes next is Jomino.
Yes.
MC you haven't touched.
Jomino and MCing were like almost at the same time.
Okay, to ingia apo
bas. Yeah, they were like concurrent.
Okay.
So